3 to 4 years ago, I was taking a night class back during my first year of college. I had attended a college where night classes were more common, so I took 2 night classes a week. I would have 2 early morning classes 3 times a week, one would be a lab. During the 2nd week of my Monday night class, my professor had assigned us into groups for our finale. We had to research and create a PowerPoint with everything we learned along the way, so every 2 weeks we would get together in class to work on it. We were also allowed to meet outside of class to work on the project too. After getting assigned into groups, there were 4 other people in my group. We'd exchanged names and such and went on our merry way. The next week, and I remember this clearly because I was taking a nap and had woken up from a Facebook message, it was a guy from night class in my finale group. He had mentioned that he had a question about class, so I asked what was up. He then responded and said he'd figured out, so I didn't respond. A couple of minutes later, he messaged me again, asking me if I had the other group members' information so he could add them on Facebook. I figured he was going to make a group chat for us, but that never happened. The next meeting, we had agreed to meet outside of class since we never had enough time in class to finish talking. But when the time came, it was only he and I who came to discuss. Instead of discussing, he started talking to me about his ex. I didn't know what to do, so I gave him advice and I just listened to him while working on other assignments for other classes. After that, he started showing up at my study area. A couple weeks went by and I didn't really mind him coming to talk to me when he felt like he needed to vent and advice. I was used to it. So one night in my Wednesday night class, I received a message from him. He had asked me to grab dinner with him. I had told him that I couldn't because I was in class and I had plans after class. He said, "Come on, it's just dinner. I have no one to eat with." I simply said, "No, I have stuff to do after class." But he wouldn't budge and kept saying I was making excuses, saying I had plans and such because I didn't want to go out and grab dinner with him. And truthfully, I didn't want to go. But I had family in the hospital and it was my only time to go see them. After denying them, I stopped showing up to class because I was creeped out. He would always sit with me in class. He would always ask me to grab lunch and dinner with him. He would be very pushy, even when I told him I had to study or that I had plans. After some time, he would message me and tell me he knew where my mom worked. I would ask how, and he would say he saw someone who looked like me but much older. But he was in fact correct, because that was my mom. A week after he messaged me about finding where my mom worked, we had bumped into each other while my mom and I were at Cubs picking up some last minute stuff for dinner. My mom had asked who the man was and I told her, "Just a dude from class. He really creeped me out." And she would be pushy also about dating him and giving him a chance because he was handsome. I told her I felt uncomfortable and that I didn't want to talk about it anymore. At this point, it was the end of the semester. We had about 2 weeks left and I still hadn't gone back to Monday night class. I was for sure creeped at this point. Non-stop messages and non-stop trying to grab food together, even after I'd said no multiple times. This one morning, I had walked out of my morning class and noticed his backpack on the floor by the stairs. He had been sitting there by himself, so I slowly backed away and went through the back stairway. My anxiety was so high. I walked away from campus and called my cousin to come get me, because my mom had driven me to school that morning. After telling my cousin about him, I was advised to transfer and file a report. Which I didn't file a report because I stopped seeing him around after I blocked him everywhere. 2 years ago, I had joined a group at a different university where we performed to a live audience. I had stopped going out to these things because I was scared of seeing him. But after some time, I figured it was safe to go since my sister and I would be together. I had also started dating someone, currently my ex now. While we were performing at a college, I noticed a familiar face in the crowd watching me. I wasn't wearing my glasses, so I couldn't really tell. But I was singing at the far right, and from the corner of my eye, I could see him, just staring at me. So, after I got off stage, I told my lead that I didn't feel safe. I then told my sister and my ex-boyfriend. I was around all my friends, so I felt safer than I did when I was alone. I thought I was safe, but as I walked back into the room to grab my jacket, he started walking towards me, staring at me. So I turned around, and I hate it till this day. I don't wear these heels anymore, but I tripped, and surprisingly, my ex-boyfriend was right behind me. He caught me and asked where I was going. He told me that since there was someone stalking me there, I shouldn't go do stuff alone in case something happened. He pulled me to the side and covered me till the man passed by. A few months after the incident, he surprisingly applied to go to the spring retreat for the student organization I was a part of. He tried adding me on Instagram, but I'm so glad I decided not to go to the retreat. It would have been a horrible 3 days of my life. So, X, let's not meet again. I have only discovered this subreddit recently, and have become engrossed in all the fantastic, creepy stories people have to tell. While my experience isn't as dramatic as others on here, I'm pretty sure it's something people experienced when they were younger. Poynton's, for you readers outside of the UK, is sort of a cheap and cheerful holiday park for families, with parks, water activities, and entertainments. It is nothing fancy, but I loved the times I went there as a kid. Anyway, I was 8 years old, so 15 years ago now, and was staying there with my mom, dad, and little sister. One night, we went to their daily evening entertainment. This is where families sit and eat, and then there'll be something like a magician or entertainer for kids, usually followed by music and dancing, all in all good harmless family vibes. After the meal, I sat at another table to chat to my friend I had met days before. You know them friends you meet on holiday and never see again. And we just had a laugh and took turns on my Nintendo DS for a bit. At the back of the room near the bar and exit, there was a practical joke shop, and my friend and I went over to have a browse. We didn't end up buying anything, and as we left, he said he was going to the toilet and I waited. Bear in mind, this was a fairly busy large room with a mini shop, bar, and stage. I was there minding my business. I distinctly remember a bunch of women, which I now understand would have been a hen party, dressed all in pink, entering and buying drinks as I was waiting for my friend. Just one of those weird, insignificant things you distinctly remember while something happens when you were younger. While I am waiting, I feel a tap on the shoulder and turn around to see a man in his mid to late 20s smiling at me. He said, "Hey, I'm the manager here and your family have gone back to the apartment in a hurry and asked me to drop you off. Come with me." Being 8 years old, you would have a tendency to listen to anyone older and seemingly friendly. But it struck me as odd, he didn't have a uniform or badge or anything like that. I think my lucky stars I had the streetwise to say something like, "Oh, I'm just waiting for my friend in the toilet and his mom will take me back." Now, I reckon I was too much trouble for him as he just strangely looked at me for a bit and swiftly left the room. Just as he did, my friend came out and as strange as this sound, I just brushed it off and forgot about it. Even as I came back to my table and saw my family there, I didn't say anything. I wasn't particularly frightened or spooked that night. The next day on the beach, I remember just sitting there thinking about it. It is something that has stuck with me ever since, and as I grew up, it dawned on me how dangerous it was. What if I went with the man? Looking back with hindsight, this was the mid-2000s in a cheap UK holiday park, with little security, and the car park was right next to the exit. I really should have told my parents so we could alert the staff, as for all I know, the man could have tried this the next night on another kid. I know now this man was most likely a pedophile or a predator, and it chills me to think these types of people can get into and hang around family resorts such as Butlins or Pontins. I hope things have changed now and security has improved. I know this tale isn't as extraordinary or dramatic as others on this sub, but I have always been more scared by the sinister, slightly unnerving stories of life. I'd like to hear if anyone has experienced anything similar.